Hello, I'm Vicki Scott-Grove, Executive Director of the Community School of Music and Arts. I'm delighted to welcome you to today's live stream concert from Tadauchi Hall in Mountain View. I would like to thank our longtime community concert series sponsor, the Applied Materials Foundation. This year, CSMA begins its 53rd year of celebrating the arts and providing access to the arts for all in our community. In addition to our students at Finn Center, last year we served 54 schools up and down the peninsula, bringing the joy of creative expression to students during their school day while teaching a skill-building, sequential curriculum aligned with the California Arts Education Framework. I want you to know we are still doing that important work this fall, joining our partnering schools in distance learning. The Community Concert Series is at the heart of our mission. In the face of COVID, we have equipped our hall to bring performances directly into your home. I hope you will enjoy our diverse and exciting offerings. Please visit our website, artsforall.org, to see the concert series and more information. You will also find our catalog of exciting online classes, and I hope you will consider donating to support our work. Be safe and stay well until we can gather together again.
Welcome to our recital. My name is Yulia Fomicheva, and I'm going to play the cello tonight.
And this is Keisuke Nakagoshi, and he's going to play the piano. Thank you for attending our recital and giving us such a great opportunity to perform for you tonight. Our recital is called Russian-born composers, and we are going to perform music written by Stravinsky, Rachmaninoff and Myaskovsky. Although their lives began in Imperial Russia, they ended up in different countries. Stravinsky first immigrated to France and then to the United States. Rachmaninoff had to leave Russia after October Revolution for the United States through Scandinavia. And only Myaskovsky chose to stay in Russia, which became Soviet Union. It is interesting how different were their composers' paths and careers, but despite difficulties, they became who they are. Firstly, we are going to perform music by Igor Stravinsky, who was born in 1882, close to St. Petersburg, in a family of opera singer. As a boy, he attended the ballet The Sleeping Beauty by Tchaikovsky, and got his lifelong interest in ballet. Although his parents wanted him to study law in the future, he still started to take private piano lessons at the age of 9, and later music theory and composition lessons. Unfortunately, when Stravinsky was 15, he got a bad review from Glazunov on one of his compositions. Glazunov said that he was unmusical. But this didn't stop Stravinsky from taking lessons. And while studying in law school, he met the youngest son of Rimsky-Korsakov, who introduces Stravinsky to his father. Rimsky-Korsakov advises Stravinsky to not enter St. Petersburg Conservatory, but continue taking private lessons in music theory. A couple of years later, after graduation from the law school, Stravinsky started to take lessons from Rimsky-Korsakov. And shortly after, Stravinsky's Russian period of work started. During this time, he creates the ballet Firebird, where a lot of Rimsky-Korsakov influence is felt. But later, in ballet Petrushka, Stravinsky became Stravinsky. At the end of this period, he started working on another piece, ballet with singing, Pulcinella. Libretto for this ballet was created together with his impresario Diaghilev, choreographer Massin, and Pablo Picasso. A couple of years later, Stravinsky arranged this ballet to Punchinello Suite for a symphony orchestra without singing. And later, in collaboration with violinist Kashansky and cellist Grigory Pitygorsky, he arranges it for violin and piano, and for cello and piano, and names it Suite Italienne. Tonight, we are going to perform two movements from this suite, Introduction and Serenata. Please enjoy. Thank you. The second composer we will perform today is Sergei Rachmaninoff. His musical path is different from Stravinsky's. He was born in an aristocratic musical family. After discovering that the boy has a musical gift, his mother hires a piano teacher who recently graduated from St. Petersburg Conservatory and offered her to live with Rachmaninoff's family and teach the boy daily. Rachmaninoff was just 4. Unfortunately, because of his father's gambling problem, the family had to sell most of their properties to pay the debt. And when Rachmaninoff was 10 years old, he was sent to study at the St. Petersburg Conservatory. A couple of years later, Rachmaninoff failed some spring exams because of his laziness and could be kicked out from the conservatory. But his mother decided to transfer him to Moscow's conservatory to study with more strict teacher, Nikolai Zverev. This was a great decision because here Rachmaninoff grew a lot as a pianist and as a composer. Unfortunately, Sergei Rachmaninoff was suffering from depressions, which appeared during different parts of his life. As a result, he pretty much didn't compose for a long period of his life. But we still can enjoy many great works written by him, and one of them is Prelude and Oriental Dance, dedicated to a great cellist and Rachmaninoff's friend Anatoly Barandukov. Let's enjoy.
Thank you.
At the finale of our recital, we chose a less known in the United States composer, Nikolai Myaskovsky. His life began in 1881 in Imperial Russia, in the family of an engineer officer of Russian army. Although Nikolai Myaskovsky learned piano and violin as a child, he was discouraged from having a musical career and entered military like his father. However, at the age of 15, he was inspired to become a composer after listening to a performance of Tchaikovsky's Pathetic Symphony. After completing his training as an engineer, he started to take private lessons, private piano and composition lessons from Glier and Krzyżanowski. And at the age of 25, entered St. Petersburg Conservatory to study with Lyadov and Rimsky-Korsakov. He was the oldest student in his class, and here his composing career started. It goes without saying that Myaskovsky was the father of Soviet symphony and was awarded the Stalin Prize 5 times, more than anyone else. Besides 13 string quartets, 9 piano sonatas, violin and cello sonatas, and many, many other pieces, he wrote 27 symphonies. In 20s and 30s, his symphonies were quite frequently performed in Western Europe and in the United States. Myaskovsky became a professor in composition at the Moscow Conservatory at the age of 40 and influenced many great composers who were studying with him, including Boris Tchaikovsky, Adam Khachaturian, Dmitry Kabalevsky, Rodion Chedrin, and many, many others. Tonight we are going to perform 2 movements from his second cello sonata, which he dedicated to Mstislav Rostropovich. Please enjoy. Well, our recital is now finished. We hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much for attending our concert and giving us such a great chance to play for you. As you may imagine, it is difficult for us musicians to perform live during this time of COVID-19. And we really appreciate that it happens. We would like to thank CSMA for providing this opportunity and organizing concerts despite all the additional efforts and work. Especially, we would like to thank the music school director, Carrie Campbell, concert manager, Claire Kim Shin, and event assistant, Tonya Pierre, to help us bringing this concert to your living room. I also would like to thank Keisuke for such a great collaboration and for helping me making this recital happen. Thank you for listening. Stay safe and continue enjoying classical music. Good evening.